past the fridge, and in the back they've got aluminium, copper and steel pipes. The steel pipes are joined onto the copper and the steel with a lock ring. And in the factory where they put the lock ring on, they clean the anodizing, which is that silver bit off the pipe, and the pipe rusts through and there's a leak here. This whole bit comes loose. Now we cut the back of the fridge open and I've cut this off here. Now we got to join this on here, but this pipe is all rusted. Now how we do that is we get these little pieces or tubes that we scavenge from old fridges, which is aluminium, and there's copper, and there's a copper to aluminium joint there, and we prepare it so that this aluminium fits on there, and we do an aluminium weld here. There's copper and we can join a nice copper pipe. The disadvantage of this, when you weld it, a tremendous amount of heat will damage this joint. So to overcome that, we clamp this into a flaring block like this, and when you do the weld, the flaring block absorbs all the heat. But this flaring block is quite heavy, so what I do is I cut a little hole into the foam and stick this in there, and I prop it up with a screwdriver like that, so it sits nicely and securely there, and we can do our weld. Okay, now this flaring block is held on by a piece of wire, and I've propped it up here because when we do our weld here, this aluminium becomes very soft and we don't want it to move. So I'm going to get the torch and start doing the aluminium weld now. Okay, we use the oxyacetylene, which is a flame, and this flux is a very high glare, so we use dark glasses. And we use the aluminium, weld it onto the aluminium. We give it a couple of minutes to cool down, and then we'll attach a piece of copper to this, put it back inside the wall, close it up with some foam, and leak is fixed. The aluminium weld is done now. I've cut this rusted piece of pipe off there, and we're going to put a piece of copper in between here. This is steel onto copper, which we can do with silver solder, and the copper to copper, there's a special rod for it. So I'm just going to prepare this piece of pipe to fit here. This copper pipe has got an internal thickness of 1/4 inch, and we clamp it in the flaring block and we swage it. We stretch the inside open by hammering this 1/4 inch swager into it, and it gives you a nice swage there which will fit on there, and that we can weld with silver solder, and we'll just make this piece to go up, which you can just bend on your thumb like that. Bend it a bit more. Copper pipe is very soft, and we'll probably cut it about there and swage that side as well. Okay. Cutting it we do with a pipe cutter, which we just rotate. There's a little blade, put some tension on it. When you snap it off, it makes a very nice cut, and we just swage it, clamp it in a flaring block, and we just tap the 1/4 inch swager in there. Now both sides are swaged, pipes in there, and that one will fit in there like that. So there's two welds we do. I'm just going to get the stuff to weld that. Okay. When we weld, this foam is quite flammable, so we put a little metal plate behind it. It's just an old piece of plate to stop the flames from getting onto the insulation and starting a fire. A welding rod which is referred to as silver solder, but there's over 200 different types of silver solder. So this one is Matty Braze 34, which has got a very low melting point and is ideal for welds like this. Okay. We use a flux powder. Weld is done, copper to steel. Where I welded the steel, it removed the top coating, which will make it rust very quickly. But before we close this all up, we will put a rust protective coat on there. Okay, I'm just going to weld it. The copper to copper, which is done with this rod, it's called silver alloy. You don't need any flux. And it melts very easily, and it flows very nicely. It has a perfect weld that will never leak if it's done properly. There we go. Now, before we close this up, we just do a pressure test to make sure there's no leaks. Okay, let's do the pressure test. We do the pressure test with a bottle of Freon gas, the extremely high pressure. This gas is called HP80. It's an extremely high pressure gas. In room temperature, this bottle has probably got close to about 140 psi, which is a high pressure. We send the pressure up the pipe, and we're going to check for leaks here. Apply this stuff on freely, and if there's a leak on one of my welds, it will show bubbles. No bubbles there. No bubbles there. And the aluminium. It doesn't look like there's any leaks, but the aluminium weld has got a bit of flux on. We just remove the flux because that could be covering up a hole. Putting some of this on, and we can confidently say there's no leaks. So we'll just clean this all up, put a rust protection, push this all back, and close this up. Check. That one looks good. That's fine.
Okay.
This is the rust protection liquid. I just use my finger, put it on quite generously. forms a chemical reaction with the steel and forms a coating which is very difficult to rust. And this is also a steel pipe, so we put the same on there very generously. And within about 10 minutes it will turn black, chemical reaction complete, and it prevents rust from forming.
Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up, and if you'd like to see more videos, subscribe to our channel.